today we'll be doing our hearts of palm, mushroom, and tofu poke. So let's get started with the ingredients. Here to my right, I have some kahuku ogo, or limu. Ogo and limu are the Hawaiian words for seaweed. Right here next to it, we have some sea asparagus. It's a very briny ocean vegetable, also grown at the kahuku farm, which is actually called Ola Kai. Right here we have some wax beans from our down by our farm here on campus at Leeward, done by our horticulture class, sponsored by Daniela Elliott. And also some heirloom baby tomatoes that they supply for us. They also supply for us some beautiful beets right here. So we have some roasted beets. Next is just fried tofu, very firm. Some steamed butternut squash. Hearts of palm, which you can see here to my left. This is the edible part or edible bud of the palm tree. This is the bottom part of the hearts of palm. When you refer to it when you're ordering it at the restaurant, you want to get the bottom because the top is more fibrous. The bottom, you can actually julienne it, and it has a texture and a taste, a cross between asparagus and broccoli. Here we have some pea tendrils. These pea tendrils, they're just the delicate part of the pea shoot, the leaf. These parts come off of the stem. This is from Mari's Garden in Mililani. Next we have, obviously, a heart of palm steak, a steamed steak, half a steak, of a butternut squash, some Eva sweet onions julienne, very thin, some more fried tofu, and right here, if I can show you, this is roasted kukui nut with no salt. We call it inamona, used to flavor pokies, ahi pokies, or any poke. Right, top here, we have shimeji mushrooms. These are edible group of mushrooms found in East Asia and parts of Europe. And some red breakfast radish. Okay, so let's start on some procedures for cooking first before we put together our poke. First, I want to talk about blanching and shocking vegetables. So when you blanch and shock vegetables, you want to have, right here, we just have some boiling water. You want to have a briny tasting, like the ocean, I would say. You want your water to taste because it's going to add flavor to your vegetables. And also, it's going to add color because the chlorophyll if you're doing something green. So we're just going to blanch these green beans. And then we're going to shock it. We still want it to be crunchy. So once we see the color come out and evolve, we're going to shock it. We're going to stop the process of cooking. Right here, the boiling water. Into the water bath, or ice bath. Alright, so there's blanch and shocking of vegetables. Next, I want to go over how we roast our beets. Beets are from right down there in our garden, our horticulture class here at Leeward Community College. Very nice beet here. Simply going to put some cooking oil on top, a little bit of salt, pepper, and all I did was get this beet here. I'll do this one too. Salt, pepper, a little bit of oil. And these are rinsed, obviously. Pour in some water, just maybe about 3/4 of an inch high in your pan. Then carefully get some foil. Make sure it's covered tight. And you place this in your oven, 350 degrees. We use convection ovens here on high fan until it is fork tender, meaning if the skewer can go straight through very easily, just like potatoes. Okay, so here we have the beet that was roasted. It's very soft. Peel it. A good technique is to peel it with our clean towels. Skin comes right off. We have a steak. And I'm actually gonna go and use a little hole puncher here. A little cookie cutter. We make a perfectly round piece of beet. Next, I want to talk about searing. Searing and scoring our hearts of palm and also our squash to give it texture, a different color, and a different flavor profile. We're gonna actually somewhat caramelize the natural sugar and the vegetables. So here we have our hearts of palm steak. And carefully score it. Scoring means cut, but not all the way through. And cross score. All right, and I did the same here with this butternut squash that was steamed already. Okay, so we have our scored hearts of palm, scored steamed butternut squash. Go on to our shimeji mushroom. So you want to keep this whole. Just tear a little bit of it off. These are white. These are brown shimeji. So just tear it off. Leave the root on for now. And basically, we're going to sear both of these with the mushrooms. Salt and pepper both sides. And get ready to sear. Want a nice amount of oil in your pan. Viscosity of oil, smoking point. How can we tell when to put in our food? We're gonna have that feeling. So we're also looking for the smoking of the pan and also the change of the viscosity of the oil. So it goes thick to almost thin. That's when we know we can put in our vegetables. Okay, so first I'm gonna put in, scored side down, only one side, my hearts of palm. Scored side down also of my butternut squash. And I'll add in my mushrooms right now. Take these out first. Salt. Pepper. You want to hold down carefully, don't burn yourself. You want to hold down that steak. Nice golden brown. You want to hold down the steak and the butternut squash steak. You want it to be like, you want to treat it almost like a skin of a fish when you score the fish. You got to press it down so it cooks it all and it cooks flat. some of this already. We're ready to do our plate up. So we'll be right back with our plate.